I'm Judy Kaczarek, and this is my friend, my neighbor, Nazarena, and we've been neighbors for several years. When Nazarena moved into my neighborhood, we became good friends that could talk a lot, and we have very good conversations about almost everything. The things that I remember the most of all, though, is a conversation that you and I had that you probably don't remember so much, was that we were talking about who Jesus is. And you shared with me a little bit about your background and a Muslim background. And you said, oh, yes, I know about Jesus, that he was real, that he was a good man and a prophet. And so then I shared with you who Jesus was to me, and that he was my Lord and Savior, and he died on the cross for me, and that I had a personal relationship with him. And but that stuck with me for a long time. And so I started praying that you would know that Jesus was not more than, he was more than a good man that walked the earth, but that he died for your sins. And I prayed that you would know who Jesus really was. And so as the years went by, you know, we had families and we kind of lost the connection that we had before. And but I would always remember you as I drove by your house and wanted to just ask God to show Nazarena who you really are. And I shared with another neighbor who is a believer, and so we were praying for you, and for several years we prayed for you. And and then one day, about 4 months ago, this neighbor called me and she told me that she had good news to tell me that would make me very happy. And so she shared that you had just told her that you had just given your life to Christ as your Savior. So can you tell us how you really came to the Lord Jesus as your Savior? When did you make that decision and why?
This has been a long road to the Savior, and I want to personally thank you, Judy, and Bev, for praying for me all these years. I had no idea that you were praying for me to come to the Lord, because we were brought up as Muslim, of course. I'm an imam's daughter, even though he's retired now. And he was very staunch and strict in our beliefs in Islam. And, you know, I told my husband that there was no way that I was ever going to change from Islam to Christianity. And with that said, he was afraid of actually losing me. And so he said his Shahada and became a Muslim. But he said he really didn't say it with the intention of being an actual Muslim. He just said that so that he wouldn't lose me. And over the years, too, he has been secretly hoping and praying, too, that I should become a Christian. And it was the time, I think, we went to see the movie The Passion of the Christ that I started thinking about my salvation, actually. And but then, you know, with family visiting and them enforcing Islam, I said, no, there's no way that I can become a Christian, you know. And the years went by. Then I started watching these Christian apologists and how they were refuting the Quran. And then, you know, I started reading and started delving a little deeper and started asking my dad questions without letting on that I would even want to accept Christianity. And he would tell me, why are you asking me all these questions? I'm praying for you that you bring up your children in Islam. So the time period when I started changing my mind and when I finally accepted Yeshua as my Lord and Savior was November of 2020. And I was watching a video about how Muslims actually celebrated Ramadan. And I saw this video and I knew, I even shouted out, I need to be baptized like yesterday. Because the Holy Spirit was working on me that day, especially that you can no longer follow this religion. You have to become a Christian and you have to become a follower of Yeshua. And that is the day that I profess to the Lord that I am a follower of His and I love Him and I worship Him and I sing to Him. Him only, He is my true God. He is my loving God, whereas my former religion, they would teach you have to be God-fearing and not God-loving. I have a somewhat calmness in my life now, and to me, our triune God is everything. And second of all, Islam is a religion where you have to be God-fearing. But Christianity, I realize it's a relationship that you share with your Creator. And that makes it more personable, you know, that you can talk to Him at any time of the day. And it's just like the Holy Spirit, you know, would have wanted for you and Beverly to pray for me so that I could know the real Jesus. Because like a couple of months ago, too, I became ill and went to hospital with COVID. And my family couldn't visit me. And that I know for a fact that the Holy Spirit was there. My Abba in heaven, Yeshua, my Lord and Savior, they were with me. I know that because I was so afraid to go into hospital, but I sort of calmed down because, you know, I started praying. And, you know, I would talk to my husband every night and tell him that, you know, this is the miracle that I was praying for. You know, I wanted my children to accept Jesus as well. And I felt that I couldn't get through to them. I prayed for this miracle, and I know in my heart that Yeshua made me the miracle in order for them to at least to take a peek into the Bible. I found the truth, and the truth definitely shall set you free. So I have this really, I have a calmness about me. Now I would love to tell my family because the Lord means everything to me, everything. So I am so proud that I'm a Christian. I feel this heavy load lifted off my shoulders. And I pray every night that my family would see this and that they would come to the Lord as well. Will be the happiest day in my life.